David, you represent the food service industry. Most recently, health authorities and federal and provincial governments have urged restaurants to shut down. I'm wondering, how bad is that? How bad is that impact on restaurants?
Well, the situation is pretty bad, actually, for many reasons. And the first one being not really what the government does, but basically the fact that there's not a lot of customers anymore because everybody follows the health requirements and the recommendations from public health. So and also there's been some recommendations from government to shut down restaurants. But most places in the country, they still allow, and even some cases, they promote delivery, takeout, and also drive-thrus. So in a way, some restaurants are able to do business, but let's not kid ourselves. It's a carnage out there.
How big of a percentage, though, is takeout? And is it enough to help these restaurants survive? Is it enough to help them pay that monthly rent?
Well, first and foremost, there's about 45% of all the restaurant operations right now that are completely down. So, I mean, they have 0% because either they're mostly in the full service gamut kind of restaurants, and they don't they don't do delivery, and at the same time they don't do takeout, so they cannot move forward. But even for operations that have takeout and delivery, it's really really a hard time, and business is down anywhere between 35% and 50%. So no, of course, delivery and takeout cannot make up for the loss of revenues, but at the same time it's a way for some of our members to stay alive, to stay up, and to hope for the wave to pass and to be able to survive down the line. It's a very hard time for everybody, but I would say for the independent operators, it's been especially hard.
We have spoken to some economists at the Financial Post who have suggested that the jobs numbers in the second quarter are going to be double-digit unemployment numbers.
Yep.
Do you have any idea what that picture looks like for jobs numbers when it comes to restaurants? And I guess a follow-up to that is foreseeable closures, for restaurant closures.
Yeah, we work some very good numbers ourselves. We also work with the National Restaurants Association in the United States because both economies are affected a little bit the same way. Usually we say that there's 1.2 million workers in food service. We need to understand some of them are students, some of them are seasonal. So for example, we take the number of 1 million regular workers in the industry. We expect short-term, anywhere downturn between 35 and 50%. So that would be 350,000 to 500,000 people that would be laid off only for the food service sector. So we talk full service restaurants, quick service restaurants, catering, and bars and drinking places. So we understand that there's an onslaught in the industry in terms of job losses. This is why we ask a lot of things from the government regarding employment insurance, but also to cover some temporary foreign workers and other people that might not be readily available for EI benefits.
What other kind of assistance can the government offer in terms of relief? I mean, some of these restaurants still have a rent due on April 1st.
We could say that rents and mortgages are probably the number one thing on our mind right now because, well, first you got most of them have a payment coming on April 1st, or at least, you know, the crisis started in terms of the government measures around, you know, March 11, March 12th. So anybody within a period of a month at least would have a rent or a mortgage to pay, whether they pay it on the first of the month or another day. So this is an immediate concern. The other reason it's an immediate concern is because usually this is the biggest fixed cost for operators. So we've asked government to do something. They're doing a lot of things regarding giving a line of credit to the banks, making sure that the mortgage insurance in Canada can play its role. So this is a first step. But then we need to look at other fixed costs and other costs and making sure that businesses can maintain the cash flow that they need to keep some people on payroll and to wait for the wave to pass and to stay alive. Among those, of course, alleviating or deferrals in terms of GST on HST, even a cancellation for Q1 would be interesting because we don't expect a lot of revenues and a lot of profits and benefits in Q2, that I can tell you. The other thing, so anything that can be a short-time help, a deferral, we've worked with some municipalities to have deferral on property taxes, commercial property taxes, and there's also provinces that are making an effort. So we just want to make sure that people stay alive, and for that they need to be able to keep being in business as much as they can, manage cash flow, and get deferral and main payments.
David, I've heard you mention, you know, riding this wave out, and at this point, it's anybody's guess how long this wave is going to last. But I'm wondering, from your perspective, what does normal look like? When we go back to a sense of normalcy, are people going back to these restaurants, or is there this pall or this tone of, you know, is it still safe to go back?
First part of your question, you know, if anybody in the country has a crystal ball to know exactly when this is going to end, I got to tell you, I'm a buyer. And if someone is interested in selling a crystal ball, because we have not 100% idea. We just want to make sure that we can respect whatever public health, provinces, and federal government says, because the first priority is to make sure everybody is safe, including workers in the industry. And at the same time, we think that when confinement starts to ease and people are able to get back and to get, you know, to different places, gather together once again, we think we are one of the industry that will be at the forefront of the relaunch of the businesses and the economy. Is going to be very important to make sure a lot of restaurants stay alive, because people will want to go out and they will want to go places. Now, we understand there's going to be some people are going to be scared of just getting out and going to different places. It will be part of our role, and also with the help of government and other stakeholders, to rebuild the public confidence and to make sure people are confident to go and sit in the dining room. We also think this is why it is so important that delivery, takeout, and drive-through keep moving, keep going on during the crisis, because then people don't lose 100% their habit of going to food service, and they understand that we play an essential service now, after the crisis, and for the years moving forward. So we're really grateful for government who gave us the opportunity to keep doing some kind of business. It's going to make the work so much easier when everything starts back again.